visual sort of layout so that I can kind of tweak things if I need to, because I will be moving in late August, so this will be the first time I move out of my parents' house, and it would be really cool to try to figure out what exactly I want, because I do have a lot of visual ideas happening in my head. So I'm going to be cutting and pasting some stuff. Okay, so what I have so far, I'm basing this off of a two-bed, two-bath apartment layout. It's basically going to be a house, obviously, but essentially what I'm thinking, based on the image that I'm looking up on Google, here it is, a bedroom. Here's the other bedroom where my roomie would be. Here is a sort of outdoor patio area, so I'm gonna actually knock this wall out. Essentially, this space, there's a wall here, but because there's gonna be a restroom, let's make a restroom right around. Let's make the restroom right about here. Take this. Should pull out a little bit. I think if I'm here, going into the bedroom, from the bedroom, I'm going through this door. I have a toilet, a sink, and a shower. I think that's enough room. I really hope it's enough room, but we can adjust as we go. So, from here, let me tear down this wall right around here. And essentially, it's going to be like a half wall or a gate. Maybe put this one back here. Okay, guys, this is where we're at, so this probably looks drastically different than what it had looked like earlier. So essentially, we have like a front door right here. Let's see. I like kind of modern looks. I don't want any of those. Let's stick to this one. Okay. So let's say this is the front door right here. Seating area. study, essentially. I actually knocked down the walls for this corner room that I had because I'm thinking, like, in theory, if there's gonna be a weird hallway to the right, which is, like, not ever a thing in houses, I think, it'd be nice to have open space here so you don't feel so, like, crowded or claustrophobic in this weird hallway. But yeah, so I think we'll go start getting to work on putting a little bit of furniture down so I can tell proportion wise that everything is correct. So I'm just gonna lay down random things. They might not be an exact, like, correct style of something that I would like, but we're just gonna play around with things. Actually, the toilet should not be directly in front of the door. It should probably be around, maybe here. Let's just plop that down, make sure everything fits. Alright guys, this is where we're at so far. So I did a bunch of windows up here. Got the roof that changed out the tile. I really liked these old kind of orangey brown deep colors. Contrasted with black. I wanted the black huge windows to bring in natural light. But I wanted black because it accented the fences there. And I just brought it all around. The bathrooms will be very exposing. But, I mean, it's chill. They're, like, isolated or whatever. Even the dining room is gonna have, like, a huge natural light. I guess dining room and whatever room this wants to be. I'm actually pretty proud of that. Like, look at this shot. It's, like, kinda cute, you gotta admit, right? The color clashing here doesn't really make me happy, but I really enjoyed the style of the sliding door. I'm not 100% sure if... Oh, wait. Yeah, they don't have the color that I would really be into. I mean, I guess we could do one of these sliding doors. But, I mean, where's the fun in that, right? So, next is to put down the floor. In the bedrooms, we're gonna do like a normal carpet brown color. Let's go with the blush. You can't beat this normal beige color. I've always lived in houses that had ample amounts of carpet. Never in any houses that had a lot of wood, which I do love wood, don't get me wrong. But I just, in a bedroom, it just seems too cold to me, you know? Let's go with more of like, not that dark. Maybe around here. It's kind of a cooler tone to me, but no, not at all. Let's try this one. I'm not against that. Let's try. I just want to see what other options there are. I don't want it too orangey. I kind of want it almost yellowish. This is red. This actually looks pretty good, guys, not gonna lie. At least for a somewhat beginner So I should have gave myself the bigger bedroom. But I mean, I'll put them both in my own style. The other room, we could probably do like a forest green. I'm not an artist, but I've always loved these things. Do that. I do have books. was going to say it's a little too matchy-matchy, but I think the correct thing to say is this is not my style per se. The colors are pretty accurate to what I would like, but I don't think this is my style. Like, I like very Scandinavian, super minimal, like this, like a Malm.
Yeah, it's like about from IKEA, like a Malm dresser.
Thank you. sucks for lefties, since everything is always mounted on that side. Actually, no. When you go to the restroom, like public restrooms, they're mounted on either side sometimes, right? Let's put some wall art. That was one thing that I wish I had thought of. There's like no space for wall art, and I really like doing that. I guess we could put some sort of stand here, because there's this like an empty space.
Maybe.
Thank you. would make sense. Now again, orange squeeze, neon pop. It's kind of fun. It's pretty tacky. Jump rope menu, that can be kind of cheesy too. necessarily